In the last tutorial, we introduced the basics of building, publishing, and maintaining applications on Momen. Today, we focus on three core areas of application building: UI, data, and actions, helping you gain hands-on experience with Momen so you can confidently build and manage your applications. Let's jump into the first part, building your application. First, let's go over positioning options for arranging components. Momen provides three positioning types: relative positioning, absolute positioning, and fixed positioning. Relative positioning allows components to be arranged in relation to their parent container. This creates flexible layouts where you can control the layout direction, spacing, and alignment through the parent container setting. When you enable the wrap option, components will automatically flow to the next line as needed. Fixed positioning locks components to the viewport, maintaining their position even during page scrolling. This is useful when elements that need to remain accessible at all times, such as navigation bars. Absolute positioning fixes components to specific coordinates within their parent container. These components remain unaffected by other elements, making this option ideal for static elements such as icons and images that need precise placement. Next, let's look at conditional containers. Conditional containers allow you to display different UIs based on conditions. Simply drag in a conditional container, define cases, and set the condition for each case. For example, you might show a login button for guest and user information once logged in. Now that we've tackled advanced UI settings, let's move on to data interactions. In the basics, we saw how to create a data model and table, but often, tables in applications need to relate to each other. For instance, a user with multiple posts. This is where relationships come in. You can set up one-to-one or one-to-many relationships between tables, like linking a user table with a post table. And this allows you to view related data, for example, viewing all posts by a single user and making data handling more efficient. In this example, I can fetch the author name via post table because I have created one-to-many relationships between these two. In addition to database, Momen supports external data fetching via API. Set up your API, select the request type, and you're ready to go. You can bind custom remote data to the page, and then select the API you want. Then any component can bind to the API to pull in external data. Components like list and selected views can dynamically bind data from tables or APIs, making them ideal for displaying frequently changing content. For other components, bind remote data to the page level first so it's accessible for all components across a page. Once the data filtering is set up, you can bind this data to any component using the in-page data, remote data option. We use our blog detail page as an example to show you how to bind the data to different components on a page. First of all, we need to bind the block table to this page, and we set the data filter. Once the page data is binded, we can select components and use the in-page data, remote data to bind any fields we want in the table. Filtering, sorting, or using the instinct data options can refine data directly in a server request, saving time and boosting app performance. In app development, you often need to filter data based on specific conditions. Set up conditions to apply different filtering rules, allowing to create tailored views. For example, you can show different blocks depending on categories a user clicks on. This example explains how to show different blocks depending on the categories. Momen also supports data binding with conditional data and formulas. You can apply math, array options, or date and time functions to data as needed. This is an example of how to bind the formula data to calculate the string length. Conditional data will show different content based on conditions. For example, on Momen's AI page, users can invite friends to get tokens. We set a condition to display users' inviting counts. If a user hasn't logged in, it'll show empty text. And once the user signed in, it will automatically display the number of their invites. With data covered, let's move to actions. We'll start with creating data. This corresponds to request data mutation action. Configure this action to components. You can insert the data into the database. Momen has over 100 built-in actions like AI, payments, and navigation. If these actions cannot meet your requirements, you can custom actions by API. For example, on Momen's education landing page, when the user submits the form and all information are correct, we'll open the education plan for this user's account. Here, we configure an API that grants education plan. Then on Submit button, configure Request API action to the button and configure the input parameters, and then you're all set. For more complex workflows, there is Actionflow. This feature combines different nodes into a flow, including CRUD operations on the database, third-party API calls, code-block nodes, AI execution, etc. Actionflows can be triggered by user actions like clicking a button, or automatically through scheduling, data changes, or webhooks. Similar to configuring front-end actions, Actionflows also support conditional branching for handling complex logic. Now let's jump into AI. Before using this action, you need to set up your AI configuration. Momen AI is an integrated AI agent builder that allows you to choose a large model, configure prompts, set context from multiple data sources, enable tool calls, and customize output. Once configured, you can use the AI request action on the front-end pages or within Actionflows. Just like with AI, you need to configure login in advance. You can find it in your project setting. Momen supports multiple methods from email to username to SSO. Once set, you can add login actions to your components. Payment action is available for Pro plans. Momen has integrated Stripe payment. Activate payment configuration in the settings, and you're ready to let users complete transactions right from your app. Once the app is built, it's time to publish. Data security is essential. Momen's permission system lets you implement role-based and attribute-based access control for tables, APIs, and action flows. Additionally, Momen supports row-level and column-level permissions for even more granular control. After setting everything up, hit publish. Momen provides a free domain, but to boost your brand and SEO, you can also add a custom domain. This feature is available for premium plans. As your app grows, so will its resource requirements. Momen provides a project detail panel where you can monitor computing resource usage in real time. Each plan includes a set amount of resources, and you receive notifications if you begin to run low. You can upgrade your plan, purchase additional resource packages, or add single-tenant servers to ensure smooth performance. That's a wrap. In this 20-minute session, we've explored the ins and outs of Momen, covering advanced UI, data, and actions. We look at how to use layouts, conditional containers, data sources, action flows, and AI, all structured around the three core elements: data, UI, and action. We hope this session helps you understand Momen better and equips you to build apps confidently. Thanks for tuning in, and happy building!